For 31 years, games characterized by large parts of the brilliant and the rest by a mean spirit. Last time this year will be coming on Saturday, the final day of the season. Will it have the same meaning for New Jersey? Will it have the same meaning that today does for the New York Rangers? Pierre McGuire and the Rangers' top playmaker, Derek Stepan.
Thanks very much, Doc. You've won four of your last five games. What's been the key to that?
You know, we're playing a simple game right now. We're just trying to forecheck and put as much pressure as we can early on.
When you think about your team, last year you got knocked out in the Eastern Conference Final in Game 6. You have a chance to end New Jersey Devils' season as it lasts today. How do you do that?
Play the same way we played for the last four games. Jump on them early and tear back-to-back and try to get on them early.
Derek, everybody talks about Marty Brodeur and the greatness over the long career that he's had. Have you guys talked about the best way to beat him?
Get in front of him and try to get one to bounce off you every once in a while.
Thanks for your time. Have fun today.
I appreciate it.
Doc.
The standings have changed since the day began. 28 save shutout by Tuukka Rask, 3-0 Boston over Florida. They leapfrog from fourth to second. What matters here today, the Rangers and Jets with three games left. If tied in points, the first tiebreaker is regulation and overtime wins. But that may not mean anything either, because the Jets, if they win their next two, they jump from ninth to third. Go figure. Here's public address announcer Joe Tolleson.
Ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you please rise and remove your caps for the singing of the national anthem. Today's colors are presented by the Fire Department of New York. And here to sing the Star-Spangled Banner, please welcome John Amarante.
See by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
About what he sings, but for all the special games over 33 years, he has been the man associated with starting a game here that is significant. He sings it with passion, and he sings it straight. John Amarante. Old adversaries today, Martin Brodeur, 21st year with the Devils, 125th regular season and playoff start against the Rangers. He's won 60 of them. 15 were ties. Henrik Lundqvist, 8th year with the Rangers, in the head-to-head meetings with Brodeur. He's won 23 of 35. Ilya Kovalchuk played only 22 minutes and 45 seconds. Oh, 43. Sorry, I left out two. In his first game after missing 11. 10 of those 11 games, the Devils did not win. Both teams come in having won their last two. And we begin with Derek Stepan and Travis Zajac on this initial faceoff. It is played on to Henrik Tillinder of New Jersey, back up to Patrick Eliash and along. Pass careened back, Tillinder flipped it, gloved down by Carl Hagelin, stepping free now. Derek Stepan played it back over for Callahan. Then along to Stepan, who rifled one, and it went off Brodeur and Watt. Tipped around behind, and Stepan will play it there. Banked behind for Callahan. Bounced off the glass. Two aside go for the battle. Lennon and Kosey Brent score! 34 seconds in! This all started because of the simple play by Derek Stepan to fire the puck towards Marty Brodeur, and it did not miss by much. The doubles are fine, but it takes a crazy carom. Brodeur is looking to the left. The puck comes back to the right, and Ryan Callahan banks it in off the right skate of Marty Brodeur.
And he's on line of communication between Kalinin and also Zajac down low, and Zbyszynski. All three guys are below the icing line. There's no resistance as Callahan tries to get to the net.
The Rangers strike first. Larson goes back. Andy Green takes over there. Good shoulder put into him. Rick Nash peels off to the slot, circles, three devils on him, and it comes on back to Strawman, who rolled it along. Some of the crowd just now settling back into their seats. The scrap continues at the half boards. It involves five players. Pitched along behind Lofty on the mountain. Rick Nash! And that one would not go. Held along further by Dinah Zubris. It will go down for an icing touch-up, and the crowd responds.
Eddie, not a lot of resistance by the Devils so far, especially with the net as a reference point on the cycle. Rick Nash coming out all alone. Where's the resistance? There isn't any. And Andy Green saves a goal. Ryan Close there all by himself. If it's not for Andy Green, it's 2-0.
Through the legs pass was off Larson. Rangers fans with their customary sense of humor went ahead regarding the visiting goaltender. Oh, and one went up to the glass as out in front was Taylor Pyatt. Chipped along further near Richards, poked into some traffic by Dinah Zubris and then led along to Kovalchuk. Decided not to golf it back along because there was someone right in his way. That was Delzato, who plays this one around off of glass support. And the Devils penned up in their own end right now until this is sent back down, and this time where it is handled by Henrik Lundqvist. They will finish the season against one another on Saturday. Offside is called.
We go back to the goal by Ryan Callahan. It's a two-on-two here, but Marek Zdlitsky will come up into this area. I mean, I think the Devils are fine here. It's a two-on-two. Not much of a problem, and all of a sudden another defenseman, Zdlitsky, comes from in front of the net. It was a two-on-two battle. And then the fortunate bounce for the Rangers off the skate and then off the net, and Callahan just throws it right to the front of the net.
Volchenkov back in the lineup today after serving a four-game suspension. Lets a second try go that rattled around behind. Henrik Lundqvist moving to his left and right, but play was a well from there. Then taken along by Ponikarovsky. Ran into the checking of the referee for a moment. Then it is Stepan turning. Ponikarovsky saw it go back, pinching along Volchenkov. Volchenkov is running too effectively there, but then it's Henrik bashing one off the board behind. Played along behind, hoping to get one to the front, but thus far not able to do it was D'Agostini. Meanwhile, it comes on out to center. Raced down there and played along by Volchenkov. Taken further and hoisted off. And Harold was run into effectively there by Callahan.
And Harold did a good job of not going to his backside there off the heavy hit from Callahan. And Callahan, another hit on Volchenkov. He's been right in the middle of three big hits on this shift, Ryan Callahan.
Isn't that always the way with the New York Rangers when they're on their game? Keep it right. We're talking about it with Liam. Ryan Callahan's a go-to guy. He's the energy guy that keeps it going. And it's about making contact at the point of attack, Eddie, as you know. Harold does a nice job. He knows it's coming, but Callahan doesn't bail out. And eventually they get puck possession. That's just a great big-time hit by Ryan Callahan.
He leads the team in hits entering today with 144. We're guessing it's probably three or four more, and we've only seen about 3.5, 10 come off the clock so far. Early stages, first period, and the Rangers have struck on Callahan's goal. He has 10 points in the last 11 games. As the Rangers head down the home stretch of this season, trying to secure one of the playoff berths that remain. More jostling, five players have moved in on this. Chris Rooney, Francois Saint-Laurent are the referees today. Tony Saracolo and Steve Miller are the linesmen. Aaron Ashen, who has played for every team in this division, threw that one in and then got tangled up near the area between the benches and Pierre.
This is Asherman, Carter, and then Kreider came in.
Chris Rooney's telling Steve Miller Carter's coming out.
Carter already in the box, and that appears to be the only one.
If you remember last time they played her in the regular season last year, Ryan Carter was involved in it.
And now it seems that Darryl Powell will go over as well.
Doc and Eddie, the Devils had a tough start yesterday too before they beat the Florida Panthers 6-2. They were down 2-0. Peter DeBoer called a timeout. That kind of got his guys settled down, and they played a real good game against Florida yesterday, arguably their most complete game of the season. They're not having a great start here so far, and maybe that's what Carter's trying to do, is get things going. DeBoer doesn't
Ladies
like the fact that Carter is getting a penalty.
New Jersey's number 20, Ryan Carter, a double minor, 4 minutes to run. The Rangers, number 8, Darryl Powell, 2 minutes for Ruffin.
Power play to the Rangers as a result of those calls.
New Jersey's Carter, 4 minutes for Ruffin. The Rangers, Powell, 2 minutes for Ruffin.
Again, the Devils must win to stay alive this season.
Devils have to put someone else in the box. Lachianov's going to go over with Ryan Carter.
Rangers this season, in the two prior games played, each team won one, and both of those at New Jersey were 0-for-7 in the power play against New Jersey. This led on now to Rick Nash. Nash jammed one in front, and it ricocheted and can be played on further and rifled back along by Brassard. Fed back to the point, kept alive neatly there by Girardi, fed on to Stepan. Stepan gave it on back now, and it is walked across by Brassard. Former Columbus Blue Jacket handed to Stepan, and a shot, and that ricocheted off of Brodeur, who responds with a jab on Callahan, who asks the referee to tell him not to do that anymore, or something like that. 40 seconds gone on the power play as of now. Led back up the wing for the carry by Nash. Nash's shot, it was high off Brodeur, and then played along by Callahan.
Not a bad angle shots by the Rangers early in this game. No hesitation at all in the offensive zone.
Eddie, you think that's something they detected in film study, that maybe Brodeur's cheating a little bit?
Yeah, I think you, when you score 14 goals in two games, you feel like you can score from anywhere.
Good point.
Kovalchuk tried to finesse it on, but it's tucked right back across and carried on by the Rangers' Derek Stepan. Wisconsin product gave it on back. Callahan tried to sky one high, and we get a stoppage of play.
Well, when you get into a face-off situation, you can run some set plays. I want everybody to keep an eye right here on Derek Stepan. He's going to win this draw back, but watch what he does after he wins this face-off. It becomes an option. Real quick play, and now the Rangers have it set up. That's beautifully set up, beautifully designed by the Rangers to be able to make a play off a set face-off. But the key is you got to win the face-off. And that's exactly what Derek Stepan did.
And that's where that dead spot in coverage is, when you're 5 versus 4 up high in the upper slot, and everybody trying to tell if you're off everything down low.
Led to the back and played on by Delzato, on for Klo, back to Delzato, and ripped on across for McDonough, then Delzato, and then Richards. And that's one in front that's chipped off of Klo, who recovers and hands it on along. Spun right back down by John Moore, and Moore is able to play this one back at center.
Boy, John Moore's been really good for the Rangers since coming over from Columbus on the trade deadline. And the biggest thing is he got his first fight the other day against Jack Skilly. His first NHL fight, handled quite well.
This one rifled on along as far as center. Delzato takes it over there. The Illinois boys can do that too, can't they?
I think it's a new coach that got it along, wasn't it, Eddie?
I only take credit for one of them.
Zuccarello tied up there by Elliott. Penalty time is up on the power play. Delzato with a shot, who to the side, and then controlled by Green, and then Nuff back down the ice, and Lundqvist will see this one come to him. 6 minutes have been played, first period, three shots, all of them off Rangers sticks. And the first one was the wraparound attempt that came from behind the goal line by Ryan Callahan. Forced around behind for the take there by Andy Green, and Green can hand it across. Zidlitsky got it ahead. Forced on now for Zubras to tap it back in and go to work on Strawman. Zubras, the big body, rolls around behind and continues to work up the board, pinching Bolchenkov, and it ricocheted off him. Hromulchuk trying to guard the blue line, but this one careened ahead. Bounce free. Hacked out by Stefan. Settled down by Hedlin. And we get a hold to play.
Tony Sandcole's going to call a high stick.
By a high stick. There's a chorus, eh, Pierre? 1-0 Rangers. Let's take a look at the Coors Light cold hard facts. And that is without their two biggest stars, Martin Brodeur and Ilya Kovalchuk. The Devils have suffered mightily. With both in the lineup, they are 13-3-4.
Yeah, that stretch without that man right there, Ilya Kovalchuk, really put the Devils in the position that they are in.
Lots of reasons for it, Miami, offensively. And then you think about all the time you lost Brodeur, too. It's been tough for the Devils. Not a lot of hockey luck this year.
When you have a guy like that in the lineup, you have to account for him. So it opens up space for other players. It's a little easier, a little more room to maneuver and make plays.
Strong work done on the steal by Brassard, but now it is forced across now for Loxiano. He is in for Jacob Josephson today. Volchenkov came in, Spain came out. This is held now by Loxianov, fed on back now for the hold by Larson, given on a cross for a shot by Harrell, blocked off and then covered by Lundqvist. Dr. Pepper 10 takes you inside the glass. Here's Pierre.
If you're a fan of the New York Rangers, you love their aggressive attack to start this game. And a big part of it, cycling using reference point. You see DeLeader and Zdlitsky down low, two defensemen. That can't happen. Use it as a reference point. It matters here. Look at all the time and space available to Rick Nash. Slow conversions. And then again, from behind the net, Brad Richards out front to Taylor Pyatt. It looks like, Eddie and Doc, that the Rangers with this aggressive cycle game down low causing some heartache for the Devils on defense.
Larson, a defenseman, played that one back in. Centered by Elias and pushed right on goal by David Clarkson, the leading goal scorer for New Jersey.
Beautiful play there by Patrick Elias. Before he went to get that puck, he looked to see what his option was, and it was David Clarkson.
Clarkson back deeper, and it is Hagelin turning with it there. Carl Hagelin tried to flip it on, taken by Delzato, pushed behind for Callahan. Roughed up there and carried to the boards and glass, and a gentle bear hug by Green. Turnaround shot is cut off by Larson, and what have we here?
Roughing penalty to the New York Rangers. Chris Rooney caught Carl Hagelin. Hagelin, not known for his physical play, gets roughed up by Clarkson. Then the free hand comes around the head of Clarkson, almost takes the helmet off. That looks like two guys jousting, but I think the free hand, Eddie, coming around the head of Clarkson got him into trouble with Rooney.
Roughing call on Hagelin at 7:36. Power play for New Jersey. Two for the last 33. Led across for a rifle shot by Kovalchuk, who is a good reason that the power play has not been effective, because he hasn't been there to be a part of it. Here's Elias beating one in front. Oh, and Clarkson has shot. It's turned aside again by Lundqvist. Pivoting with this now is Girardi. One hands it off, and it's taken by Stefan, and he's able to lay it back down.
Another good play there by Patrick Elias below the goal line. Both to David Clarkson and Henrik Lundqvist, and eyes on both.
And that speaks to your point about Kovalchuk, because they have to respect Kovalchuk up high. It opens up a lot more in the slot. You see how much time and space Clarkson has. They're paying attention to Kovalchuk.
Yeah, you're drawn to a premier goal scorer like Ilya Kovalchuk.
David, Callahan is,
yeah. It just pops right out of that soft little area. You got two Ranger defensemen going below the goal line. The player is not going to score from there. And if one guy's going to go, the other guy has to stay in front and buy some time.
Here is a chance for Nash. Toe drag is denied by Kovalchuk back defensively, but then Nash around behind and Jedlicki on him. Kovalchuk able to steal away with it. And D'Agostini can hold through traffic. 11:30 to go, first period, 1-0 Rangers. Halfway through, the penalty kill for New York. Darryl Powell out of nearby Princeton sees this one curl on around now to Kovalchuk. He can walk it across and hand one that apparently went off Harold's stick, who recovered and played it behind. Off Bernier, and a big collision behind as Girardi sent his man down. There's a penalty that will be coming up here.
That's D'Agostini.
A stick hold is the preliminary signal.
Well, there's a battle below the goal line, and watch
Girardi anticipates the hit from Matt Nagostini. And watch the stick. The stick ends up getting lodged right there. And that's where the holding the stick call is made.
Two guys have played junior against one another. Nagostini with Welch. Girardi with the London Knights. And Pete DeBoer, who used to be the coach of the Kitchener Rangers, doesn't like it at all. But he'll see the tape and he'll see the freehand of Nagostini hold on to Girardi's stick.
It looked like Nagostini was a little bit stunned on this hit. He was going to go make the hit, but Girardi beat him to the punch.
And he's holding on to that stick. There's no question he's trying to hold on to the stick.
I think he was a little out of sorts for a second there.
Fair point. That's what Dan Girardi brings, though, isn't it, Eddie and Doc? He just brings that intimidating physical presence. He can block shots and shoot the puck with all kinds of velocity.
In a huge game against Buffalo in which the Rangers scored 5 goals in less than 3 minutes of playing time, Girardi had 6 shot blocks. Season total 113. That's a little over half of what he'd have normally, because the normal season is 82 and this is game number 45. Off of Strawman, laid out by Zubras, carried on by Kovalchuk. Wants to dance on by. His pass, though, was into Ranger possession and sprawled.
See how smart McDonough was there, Eddie? He knew that that was Kovalchuk coming after Nash, and he jumped over and told Nash, I got him. You stay in the weak side lane. I got him.
Kovalchuk on down to Zubras, sized up by Strawman. Tried to feed it through to Kovalchuk, led it right into the path of Strawman, and he can shift back out. With a dozen seconds left in 4-4, Strawman is wrapped there by Andy Green. So it is Zubras filtering it through now for Harold, who settles things down with 2 to go. He can ice the puck now as he brings it on. That pass skittered away from Zajac. Penalty time is up to the Rangers, and so they go on a power play. That is somewhat abbreviated at a minute 10. Nearing the halfway point of the first period of a hugely important game. Desperately so for the Devils, hugely for the Rangers. Zuccarello cannot work his way past Bochenko. Back up the boards, and Patrick Elias can bring it on. Has Zajac with him, and a 2-2. Elias flipped one that is guided away carefully by Lundqvist, and taken to the boards and glass was Zajac. Carter fresh from the bench for New Jersey to defend against this power play as it janked off of Callahan and then sped across for Girardi.
Good stick there by Travis Zajac.
Girardi across for Delzato, cannot find his way in. Second effort by Volchenko. And off the high-ish sort of glass at center. In some places it's short, but here it is higher than normal. Brought back on now and dropped on back for Delzato and then thrown back in again by Girardi. It is Zuccarello able to play this one around behind. Norwegian-born winger saw it come back onto Girardi. Tipped away off of Zuccarello. Rushed on by Carter. Kareem back to Volchenko, who's able to spin and guide it crisply across for Green. 2-1. Penalty time up. Green with the long shot that's fought off by Lundqvist. 9 minutes to go. First period of play. The shots are 5-3. New Jersey with the last 5 in the game. Jam for Kovalchuk. Touch to Loktionov, and he couldn't get it through. Good cancellation there by Girardi. More battling, and Zubras played it along. Second effort, but it is peeled off by Nash and handed on out for a carry by Ryan Flo.
Beautiful little pass there. You mentioned that by Kovalchuk.
A bad angle shot that you're talking about by the Rangers against Marty Bordeaux there, that time by Ryan Flo.
Circle to circle go the Rangers in their own end. Kicked along now for the carry back by Stepan. He's able to drill it back in. The leading assist getter for these Rangers. Working around behind, but that skipped away and can be played by Flo. Flo tried to play the point that Hagen vacated. It ricocheted back to him off Kovalchuk. Stepan is walled there by Larson. Laid on back by Asham. Strawman across to McDonough.
Stepan said jam in the net, and that's exactly what the Rangers do, Eddie.
Well, Derek Stepan is in behind the net. After the play comes from here, the shot will work its way from Ryan McDonough. Head up all the way, looking for a stick, and this puck is redirected in front of the net. Ryan Flo in front of the net as well, with a good low shot right there. It's either Stepan or Flo. It's a
second one of the game for the Rangers.
And it's a huge mismatch. You see Lakhchyanov trying to go against Ryan Cole. That's not even a fair fight. That's just a great job by the Rangers with board play, aggressive forecheck, and jamming the net.
Jedlitsky for New Jersey. Skied by Talinger. Carried on by Henrique, and Henrique with a shot that went wide. It looked for a moment like the Devils might get two alone on the goaltender just because of fielding the bounce. But now it is Emminger. Banged one back off of Taylor Pyatt. Emminger will try again and slide it across. Moore dumped it ahead. Played geometrically over. Spotted back by Jedlitsky. Played by Podkoroski. Trouble came there. Aaron Ashton tries to step back in. Taken out of the play! And play continues. On the center for the throw into the glove of Brodeur, who hoists one out to center, grabbed off there by Carter. Carter stepping ahead and a shot, and up against the glass, and defending was Lundqvist, and a penalty will be coming up here.
Going to be on Ryan Carter.
At one end seemed like one, at the other end is. 2-0 Rangers, man advantage when we come back. Edward Jones FaceTime. Pierre is with Coach John Tortorella of the Rangers.
Coach, it looks like your team has a lot more offensive confidence since the trade deadline. What have you said to them?
Well, I think we've just been more balanced since the deal. We brought in three or four new players. I think it balanced the middle of our lineup.
Looks like you're attacking them aggressively off the cycle down low. Is that something you detected as a weakness on their defense?
Well, I think they detect our defense as a weakness. We detect theirs, and that's the way both teams play. So that's a key component of the game tonight.
That's not John tonight.
It is Carter, a trip at 13:05. The Rangers power play is 0-2. One power play shot on goal. Rangers entered this game 7-for-30 on the power play. Terrific lately as Stepan fed one in front that went off Ryan Callahan.
Callahan had a little bit more time than he realized there. This all starts because of another faceoff win in the offensive zone.
Zajac flipped one off of Brassard and back down.
And you like the fact they're going with four forwards on their power play right now? It looks a lot more confident for the New York Rangers anyways on the power play.
Yeah, I think with what John Tortorella told you since the trade, yes, a little bit more depth, more action for the coach, and playing with a lot of confidence right now. Move in the puck and move yourself. That's the philosophy right now for the Rangers.
And you can see it. I mean, they just look like a completely different team.
Brassard, number 16 in blue, has 9 points in 9 games as a Ranger. And he handles the puck right now. Halfway point of the penalty kill for New Jersey. Moving back in his net. Pitched it behind, and so does Larson, firing one up the boards, but it is held, though, at center. And then tripping up. Bubble shot that time was Delzato as play continues. They try to roll it back in, and driving along is Brassard. Good heady work there, but he's shoved down by Talinder. Delvon back, there'll be a penalty coming up. It's against New Jersey. Callahan firing it along. Do they want to give the puck up here? Apparently not. It is Moore. And then over the net. Magic shot that is deflected to the glass by Callahan. Laid on to the back to Moore again. 28 left on this one. Delzato's shot went off the glass after striking Henrique. Popped out of play and the clock stopped.
It's going to be a bench minor.
Or is it ever?
After Kovalchuk got hauled down in the neutral zone, the Devils bench all stood up and ripped into Chris Rooney. And he makes the call, Eddie. Good eye by you.
Yeah, unsportsmanlike conduct.
And a good editing ear by you, Pierre.
It wasn't really ripped the in, language you would...
No, ripped into, I think, describes it well.
Yes, thank you.
So it'll be another situation where the Devils will be short. And Patrick Elias, the alternate captain of New Jersey, is getting the explanation from Chris Rooney right now.
And five forwards on the ice on this 5-on-3 for the Rangers to start.
24 seconds of a 5-on-3. Zajac flung it away from Zuccarello and back down.
Why don't you pick him up?
Huge face-off there for the Devils and Travis Zajac.
Iron 3 working with Volchenkov and Green. Gaining the zone is Nash, and he handed it on back. Delayed there and worked by Zuccarello. Zuccarello hands it on back further. Ripped onto the corner for a try toward the front of the net that failed from Stepan. On back now for a hurried pass by Richards. And a shot by Stepan that blocked aside. Taken on and wheeled back down the ice by Andy Green. Matt D'Agostini is serving the bench. Miner against New Jersey. 1:20 left on the Rangers power play here. The shots are at 5 apiece. The Rangers have the lead in this huge game by a score of 2-0. Jab back by Steven Gionta, knifed away from Zuccarello by Green. Nicely kept though, and marched on by Richards across for a trying throw, and a combination that went from Haglund across to Zuccarello failed at the net mouth.
Boy, a great idea there by Carl Haglund. Everybody thought he was going to shoot the puck, and at the last second just was looking for the stick of Matt Zuccarello standing to the left of Marty Brodeur.
Zuccarello lost that one. Talinder tried to flip it ahead, has a second chance, and does not fail on that.
The Rangers have to continue to shoot the puck in on their power play, on their entry. Haven't been able to carry it in a lot. You get an opportunity with speed. You got to chip it in deep. Can't just chip it in. About 15 feet in there to give away by Haglund. Good play by Talinder.
John Tortorella is coming on that right now. He's talking to both players as they come off the ice. Get it in deep.
Well, that time it happens. It's swirled around past Zajac to the point. Given all across to Delzato. Shoots one. Knocked down in front. It went off Asham and is nudged ahead now for Zajac to bring it on with Andy Green. Shorthanded, Zajac popped one that went high behind the net. He burrows in after it to kill off the last 2 seconds and one. And the penalty is killed by New Jersey. Back to even strength with 3.25 to go here in the first. Moore led it across. Delzato skied one back. Harold gloved it ahead, but a hand pass accurately ruled at center. Latter stages of the first period here at Madison Square Garden. It's the Rangers 2, the Devils nothing. The NHL on NBC is brought to you by Progressive, making it easy to bundle your home and car insurance. By the Kia Optima Limited Midsize Sedan, elegance, performance, technology. And by Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. The colors that just do not mix ever since the move of a team called the Devils from Denver, Colorado in 1982. The very first game played between the two actually was won at New Jersey by the Devils, though there were a few others for a while because they were an expansion team that just never got better. Until later on, and then did they ever. Meanwhile, this is battled for. And Eddie Olczyk and those New York Rangers took care of him in a conference final in 1994. The Devils responding the following year with a championship of their own in a 48-game schedule.
Good work here by the fourth line for the Devils. Real good energy.
They were great yesterday afternoon, too, when they beat the Florida Panthers in that coming behind win. This line's been excellent since coming back together after last year's great playoff run for the Devils.
Linder connects with Kovalchuk, has Zubris nearby. That one floated over for Green, who marches in. Here's Green curling around behind. Wanted to get it in front, but that shut off. And then dealt further near Lakhdianov. He's able to see it bounce off him, but cannot control. Thrown back out by Stepan, brushed on by Callahan, taken by Lakhdianov, and a hand pass stops the clock. You're on, man.
Upcoming games tonight on the NBC Sports Network, Blues at the Avalanche.
Coyotes and Red Wings tomorrow.
Oh, that is a huge game for the Detroit Red Wings. Tuesday night, the Bruins will be in Philadelphia to take on the Flyers.
And we will be in Detroit on Wednesday night for the Kings and the Red Wings on Wednesday night, rivalry night. And somewhere a contentive player between those two franchises, Marcel Dion, remember that? Well, he was sort of the Kurt Flood case, wasn't he? Well, anyway. Guy who played for this team, the New York Rangers, and was a wonderful centerman in Los Angeles. Meanwhile, this is Green giving it on across now to Larson. As I await my law degree, this goes around behind now for Lundqvist. It's not coming. Nash feeds it ahead. Carried back on and nicely spirited across by Brassard. And thrown in on goal where Brodeur made the stop.
Nice little play there by Ryan Clough to get that puck to McDonough.
Dribbled around behind where Larson is able to take it. Hands on to Eliash. And Eliash to David Clarkson. Mystic Winger sees this one played on back and it's sailed back in where Brodeur will play on the trapezoid. Final minute of play here in the first period. Peter Harold out of Boston College led it ahead now. Paul Turovsky had trouble with the blue line. Meanwhile, it's flipped off the shoulder of Volchenkov, who is able to give it across to Harold. Harold rifled it back in, and this one blocked aside, so there is no icing on the play. Meanwhile, two-a-side battle in the corner, and it's pointed back along where Harold, or check back where Henrique was reaching for it. It's D'Agostini giving it on back, and Harold with a shot, and it's blocked off in front. May have gotten all the way through the line for it, but at any rate, it is set back around now, and Pyatt there, but we get a halt to play. No penalty coming up from all of this. Expand your hockey experience with the Verizon StarCam on NBCSports.com and NHL.com. Throughout the game, we're streaming a live ISOCam following star players like Patrick Elias and Rick Nash. The Verizon StarCam available now at NBCSports.com and NHL.com.
That's appropriate because both of them tied for the Rocket Richard Trophy in 2004 along with Jerome McGinley.
41 goals for all three of those men that year.
Down to the ice goes Kovalchuk. This one in front, making a hit by Haglund. Haglund rifled it across. Callahan with it there. Shanked one that went off Jedlicki, and he is able to step free and play it. But trouble back in the Devil's end, though it is Zajac getting it along. It is not out, and so the Rangers can keep the pressure on, though Brodeur will settle it down. The buzzer forthcoming. And a standing ovation for the home team who struck twice. Callahan at 34 seconds. Stepan 12 minutes. Coming up on the Lexus intermission report, the Rangers scoring outpost, plus the Bruins take the lead in the Northeast Division. Shots on goal, 7-6 Rangers in the first period. In goals scored, they had two, and the Devils had none. Our coverage of the Rangers and Devils, the NHL on NBC, continues in just a moment. That's a lot of real estate there. You want to know the price per square foot? I don't know, and I got no shot.
That's your rent district right there, Doc.
Rangers have the lead 2-0. Your thoughts on the first period?
Well, a terrific start, and the Rangers really outworked the Devils below the goal line in the offensive zone. That's how they created a bunch of their chances. The Devils had some chances, too. Henrik Lundqvist had to make two really good stops, and they were both on David Clarkson. But it was Patrick Elias that made the play. Watch the vision here. Look, the puck, he's going for the puck. Look at where his head is. He's saying, what are my options before I get to that puck? Great play by Elias. Great stop by Henrik Lundqvist. And then here, Patrick Elias, two defensemen for the Rangers. Girardi, McDonough going below the goal line. There's David Clarkson, and another good stop there by Henrik Lundqvist.
Among active players, that man is number 8. In the NHL, 927 points, getting closer all the time to 400 goals at 374, including two yesterday. That distinctive buzzer has sounded. For that reason, we look down on Stepan and Zajac, the same two who began the game, begin the second period now.
Travis Zajac, into that face-off win to start the period, went 7-9 face-offs.
Zajac able to outreach and clear that one to center. It's swept along now by Brodeur. So he gets a faceoff win and a very strong defensive play to begin this period. Meanwhile, this one rattled around where Elias turns, tapped it back on. Zajac is shot high off of Lundqvist and out of play. Did that get him in the helmet, Matt?
Sure did.
He's good at that too, isn't he, Lundqvist? He loves it when it hits him in the head. He kind of heads it away from the net.
Now watch the little pass in the corner.
Does that a lot, Eddie and Doc. He likes to use that noggin and steer pucks away from the net.
I have a grasp of history. Was Roman Čechmánek the first to do that on a regular basis? One of several.
Yeah, I remember Dominic Hasek doing it quite a bit.
Hasek used to do it in the morning skates. He'd tell guys to shoot at his head. I'm serious. In Buffalo, shoot at my head.
Well, it's for practice, right?
Yeah.
As long as ownership and the coach and the manager didn't hear you.
Well, this is carried back ahead now and worked on by Dinah Zubras. Two-a-side battle off Dionov there. Zubras tangled along the boards with Nash, and it's lost perhaps in the paraphernalia. But anyway, MetLife presents Inside the Glass. Here's Pierre.
Thanks a lot, Doc. Early on in the game, Eddie detected something that the Rangers are doing. They're throwing a lot of pucks from bad angles at Marty Brodeur. 7 shots on goal so far for the New York Rangers. A lot of them from bad angles on Brodeur. And you see, whether it's Nash, whether it's Ryan Klo, it's equal opportunity, even Derek Brassard. They're throwing pucks from any angle possible
on Marty Brodeur. And I got to believe they detected that maybe he's cheating off the short side pole, Eddie.
Yeah, and also, too, the guys without the puck become so important. But everybody on the ice understands what that guy's going to do with the puck, regardless of how advantageous you may think it is from the angle you're shooting it. Those guys without the puck have to get to the front of the net, at least be on your way there if it doesn't hit Marty Brodeur.
Steve Eminger saw that play develop out of his end down to the Devils' defensive end. Number 44 in blue with 99 points in his career. He's not about points, but he is reaching a milestone close. Drive by Gianta, shrugged down by Lundqvist. Played back into some traffic off of Ponikarowski to Eminger near Asham, but then taking the hit was Talinder. Ponikarowski able to escape a couple of Rangers, led it onto the back. Shidlitsky with a shot, and that one knocked down, and Brett rebound is popped to the corner, and Rick moves in for it there. D'Agostini is sealed up by Eminger, rocking on in as Ponikarowski. Fed to the half boards and onto the back. Shidlitsky with it there. Then held by Henrique. That one skipped loose and ringing from shade to center for Talinder. And rifled back in. Then Henrique. Fed back over for D'Agostini, and a bad angle shot would not go. D'Agostini curled to the outside with it. Led it onto the back. Talinder there. Then across to Shidlitsky once more. Shidlitsky back to Talinder with a wrister that's blocked on back. Henrique tapped it back in. They go to work again behind. Elias twisting with this one for New Jersey. Zajac allows it to go. Shidlitsky a shot. And Zajac was at the front of the net and tipped it to the glass.
That's some tired defenseman out there for the Rangers. Warren Eminger.
And Crowder and Asham have been out there a long time too. The centers changed, but not the winners.
Clarkson just slung one wide. Played back along by Talinder. Then Zajac. But Asham. And Shidlitsky keeps play alive again. And sealing this one up is Henrik Lundqvist.
How do you call spacing? Watch the subtle little pick right here that causes some opening for the Devils to be able to have this really good shift. Watch a subtle little pick right there. That just buys a little time. Matt D'Agostini comes all the way over so Ponikarowski can come out and make a play. More plays like that in the offensive zone will allow that spacing and that time and space to be able to make some plays. Sometimes you'll see the referee put his arm up, but you can't make contact. You can skate into that area, but as long as you don't initiate contact, it won't be called interference.
Brad Richards is waved out of the faceoff. Zubris will await Taylor Pyatt to take this draw. Left for Richards. Scaled back off, but it is Polchenkov firing it around behind. It is Lapionov handing back. Harold with a shot. Save. Rebound. And that one nearly found its way home, but a good stop by Lundqvist. Played on along further. It is battles for by Zubris, tucked on back by Kovalchuk, drive by Molchenkov, and that jousted away with a goal stick that was held by Lundqvist. Devils with four shots on goal, the only shots registered in the period so far. Flopped back in by Volchenkov, delayed offside is White now as the Devils curl out and go back on their forecheck. Led back up now to Matt Zuccarello. Gave it on the wing for a one-time shank shot by Richards. That is up the boards now for Kovalchuk, slings it on ahead, and it's carried on by Lapionov. Lapionov with a wrister, blocked away and then paddled away by Lundqvist. Forced back out again by Zuccarello. The Devils in this period have a total of six shots already. Rangers still looking for their first, but the important thing is has been the curse lately until these last two games. None of them have gone in. Brought back ahead by Bernier. Bernier flung one that is hooked remarkably toward the front of the net by Green, who is skating by. But now it's carried back out by the Rangers. Green back defensively along with Larson. And this one is played by Larson. Hopes to get it to Green, but in the way was Ryan Callahan, who had three hits in that first period. Skipped on near Kreider, and Kreider is able to step as far as center and then play it along. Strawman flung one ahead. It is Callahan reaching for that. It came across, and a backhander by Haglund is held by Brodeur.
Boy, good effort there by Ryan Callahan to get that puck right up and create the chance. Watch these stops here by Henrik Lundqvist. First shot by Peter Harrell. Right off the left pad, and then another left pad save. Back-to-back left pad saves.
Eddie, why doesn't Lachiano airmail that one to the top of the net? Because he doesn't throw his hands up. And then you see Haglund from Callahan, quick chance on Brodeur. Yeah. But Eddie, he needs to go to your goal scoring school.
Yeah, just probably in a little too tight. And that's the reason why he wasn't able to elevate. I think he was surprised too, Pierre. of that puck came right to him. And at the last second, his skates were almost below the goal line with his blade in his hands above it and just in a little bit too tight. But, I mean, really sneaky, great stop by Henrik Lundqvist on that second one.
And a great start for the Devils in this period, as Doc talked about with the shots on goal. A little surprising, the Rangers haven't continued that full frontal assault style of hockey that they played in the first period.
From this tie-up, it comes over to Tillinder, and Tillinder just looking and gets a pass ahead that's carried on by Ponikarovsky. D'Agostini turning with it there. D'Agostini with a shot that ricocheted off Moore and went wide. Tillinder gave it back in deep. Emminger had it knifed away by Ponikarovsky. Coming by D'Agostini, shoved off by Brassard. Not until he'd gotten it off the stick of Tillinder to center. So Zydlitsky peeling back and dropping one on that D'Agostini jab further. Moore can play it along, and Nash had it knifed away. Then Emminger. 13 shots to 8, New Jersey in the game. 7-1 in this period. Zydlitsky comes back to take this one from Brodeur. And this one flown on near Delzato. Nice little brush of it by him. Then Tillinder. Tennis, blue line to blue line, given back to Clarkson for a shot that is trapped and held by Lundqvist. Visit nhl.com/bracket for the 2013 Bracket Challenge presented by Verizon. Register now, make your picks, and you can win a trip to the 2014 Bridgestone NHL Winter Classic. In my bracket, I normally have Duke, but they do not have a professional team or a college hockey team. Here is Harold on a cross. Volchenkov flipped one, skittered along for Zucker, centering pass, and unable to get it was Loktionov. Meanwhile, it is helped along for Carl Hagelund. The Michigan product gave it on to Stepan, and he flung it wide. Brodeur forced it along, went off a Ranger stick, and they rule a high one. And so again, the clock stopped. Vinny LeCavalier is 33 today at Belfour. Michel Goulet, Nick Beverley, Clayton Pahal, Doug Sotart, Larry Skinner, and the Queen of England. Why is she a hockey birthday? Appeared at Maple Leaf Gardens, appeared at the Hockey Hall of Fame 2 years ago. Good enough for me. And rattled back around where Brodeur sets it up. Rattled along near Kovalchuk, challenged pretty effectively there by McDonough. Picks it up there. Forehand shot is blocked by Brodeur. The rebound lay to be played on further near Kovalchuk, but then swung in front, jabbed away by Brodeur. Carried back ahead by Zubras. Nudges onto Kovalchuk and a 2-on-2. Kovalchuk drifting to the outside and then heads around behind. Defended there pretty effectively by McDonough, by Stepan rather, with the reach of the stick. Now Loktionov back along for Kovalchuk. Strawman on him, and it's fed errantly to center. Larson waits, blasted back along, but then has to gain the zone. Larson able to play it and towed away in a good split save made by Lundqvist. Rather quiet, 17,200 watching now. Their team ahead in the game by a score of 2-0. Along with this is McDonough. Flipped it in some traffic, and it is Henrique. But then Strawman moves up through, hustling there first, Ponikarovsky, and the test is on. To a side now, working it along D'Agostini, menaced by Stepan. Meanwhile, the puck to the front, nudged on by Callahan, can be played on out by Stepan. Rangers in the role of counterpunching right now, but it is Taylor Pyatt able to play this one. Two men on him, and it is Andy Green.
Pyatt did a good job there, allowing some time to get some fresh people on the ice.
It is Moore firing, and that one that Brodeur got a piece of with his stick as it was sailing wide. Can be played on by Green. Leaping grab and a good keep there by Richards, and he slung it to the corner. Helped along off a glove and into the bench area. Everybody okay there?
Yeah.
Seemed to be. 2-0 Rangers, second period. It's time for Honda's Name That Squirt. You look at a picture from youth hockey, and then you decide. Well, he's not as tall as the net there, is he? Then he got a little bigger.
Good-looking kid.
Not a clue. Ah, it's Ryan Callahan. You know what threw me off? The orange.
Me too.
The guy from Rochester doesn't wear that, do they?
think all about kinds. Giontas, Callahan, all out of Rochester.
Steven Gionta, 11 in white. His unit is out there right now. Bernier turns, fed one on that is knifed away from him in a good defensive play by Eminger, but gotten right back again by Bernier. Turns there, Gionta there as well, and Bernier and Carter not far away. Beyond Asham's reach, Talinder played it back. Now it is Bernier with it again. Rifled it back to Zydlitsky. Takes the drop. Fed one in front and shot to the glass by Bernier.
Boy, good try there. Good look by Zydlitsky over to Bernier on that weak side.
Second time the four times for the Rangers have been on the ice, and the Devils have generated a lot of chances. I've got to think John Tortorella is wise to that. We may not see a lot of the fourth line here for the Rangers going forward.
Well, that all started. The Rangers had won the faceoff in the neutral zone after that TV timeout, and then Eminger turned the puck over in the middle of the ice, and then the Devils were able to take advantage of that. And another good strong kick by that fourth line.
Offside pass.
And this is a chance Eddie's talking about. Bernier, he's a right-hand shot on the left-hand side of the ice. He just can't get the puck to settle down.
Right.
And he double taps it, and he puts it up and over the crossbar. That's a yawning net for Bernier. Just can't finish. He's had a tremendous year, by the way, Bernier. 8 goals this year for the Devils. When you think about a fantastic season for him.
With all the injuries, he's been up and down the lineup. And there you see, not happy knowing that opportunity there. Just a little bit in front of him. Wasn't in the wheelhouse. He had to change at the last second. That's why he, as Pierre mentioned, double hit that puck as it was coming off his stick.
Doc was talking about the consistency of the Devils. There's a major reason why. Lou Lamoriello, Dave Conkey, Claude Carrier, their scouting staff, phenomenal. And that's the man that's the architect. He hires pretty good coaches too, like Pete DeBoer.
They do have to win this game, or for the second time in 16 years, and the second time in 3 years, they will be out of the postseason party. Wheeling right back. Brassard gave it up on the wing. Thrown right back in front, and Brodeur with a save as skidding to the front of the net with Brassard. And then back at center, it's carried back off.
Good shot there by Ryan Coleman. That off-wing, left-handed shot coming down the right wing board.
Played on by Strowman. Nudged across, and here comes Klo again. Klo forces it back in, tries to burrow in after it. Waltzed every inch of the way by Zubras. Right back up the boards for a good keep by Strowman. Loktionov able to strip it away from him and start it back ahead. As Kovalchuk on his left tried to filter it there, but it came back where Strowman can play for the Rangers defensively. Nearing the halfway point of regulation time. If the Rangers win this game, they would be tied in points with Ottawa. But they would not take over that position. Here is Nash feeding. Klo, a shot turned aside by Brodeur.
Well, there's some room on that short side. He had Brodeur down. He just was not able to elevate it on that short side.
Again, that plays into what the Rangers have been trying to do. I think they really think Brodeur's giving up the short side a lot, Eddie.
This one rifled back out, and Clarkson up with it there and sends it back in. Boston has already leapfrogged into the number two position in the Eastern Conference race by virtue of a shutout win over Florida today. Brought back on by Hagelin. And Scott to the corner. Chopped off of Andy Green, and Green is able to flex it on. Gets a little help there from Larson. And Larson took the hit, but got it as far as center, where it's rescued by Stepan and played back in. Rangers began the day with 8. Dumped on behind. Ottawa, the team ahead of them in 7th, but by the end of the day would have one more game. The New York Islanders are ahead of them.
People better start paying attention to John Tavares and the Islanders. They are playing tremendous hockey. Great composure in Winnipeg yesterday to win that game yesterday afternoon. And the shootout, Tavares was fantastic in that game again.
I think finally the Isles are on the radar. Shift change on now. D'Agostini comes out. There's a stray stick there just to add to the confusion. But this is New York. They're used to it. Played back in now off of Richards and back down.
For the record, that's Ron Callahan stick.
And there is a warranty, right? Played on out the center and hooked back in.
I'm sure they do have one.
There's not that work of sticks with blowtorches and things that there once was, is there?
Right out of the box and let it go.
Delzato turns around behind. Delzato able to muscle it as far as center. It's hooked on a cross, and it's Richards out of a hat trick against Buffalo. Gets
it's a second follow-through that came from Delzato, and Brodeur smothered that one. Midway, second period, still 2-0 Rangers. Edward Jones FaceTime, Pierre, and Devils coach Peter DeBoer.
They had a 2-0 lead after the first period. You've taken a little steam out of their sails. How have you managed to do that?
Well, we regrouped at the end of the first, and we knew playing last night that they were going to have a good first period. We didn't help ourselves, took some penalties. It wasn't the start we wanted, but we had no choice but to regroup between the first and second and come out with a better game.
Thanks a lot, Peter.
A better game exactly here in the second period for Peter DeBoer and the New Jersey Devils. A little more urgency, defensemen getting involved a little bit more. The Rangers have a little pushback in the last 3-4 minutes.
They're not taking any penalties. I think that helps them a ton.
Those are hard minutes. I mean, those are taxing minutes when you're short-handed.
Good steal there. Fed on for a shot. Transition to the middle of the ice for the New York Rangers. What a shot by Taylor Pyatt. Anton Lechenkov tries to clear the puck. It's stolen by Brad Richards. Pyatt in a high slot, and he goes top shelf on Marty Brodeur, but the giveaway's the key.
Stick on the ice by Richards. Stick on the ice by Pyatt. Give him a target and then snap it home. Fifth goal of the year for Taylor Pyatt. That's like foul money for the Rangers in this kind of game.
And Zuccarello going hard to the net, allowing Pyatt some time and some space to be able to let that quick wrister go.
Celebrating his 800th career regular season NHL game. A stat that I think only we care about. Certainly the player does not take great notice of that, but he's gotten a goal that's huge for his team. Has given them a 3-0 lead. Pyatt's fifth from Richards at 11:56.
Where it's anticipating being the eyes of that defenseman. Where is he going to go with that puck? Take away his options. Where is he going to pass it? And Richards gets the puck, gives it to Taylor Pyatt. There you see the quick wrist shot. He caught Marty Brodeur in between, maybe anticipating a slap shot of some sort, or maybe even passing back to Brad Richards with no hesitation at all.
Here's Eliash with Zajac breaking on! Skied high by Hagelin, and Callahan able to finesse it free and peel away from Talinder, pushed it around behind Jedlicki, back up the boards, whipped back along, and can be played by Delzato. Fed off a stick to center. Lundqvist has faced 16 and gotten 16, and you mentioned two of the first period saves on David Clarkson. Well, there was the best one by my count of the afternoon. Twisted on around because it would have been a response goal by the Devils to get themselves back to within two. And it was a nice setup where Zajac was robbed. Brought back ahead now and dragged on by Ryan Carter.
Go, 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 go.
So Girardi rattled it around, but Steven Gionda saw it skip off. Aaron Asham with it there. And that one ricocheted back off Peter Harrell. Harrell glides ahead and connects back up the wing to Cutler. He's got Gionta breaking, let it back, ball, chip off a shot, blocked and then covered by Lundqvist.
That's a good job of transition hockey. Berenson-Litsky put the puck up in the air, create a foot race situation. Elias, quick stick, Travis Zajac shuts it right down. Lundqvist, what a job. Quick tap play, Eddie. You love the way Zajac goes to that, but what a response by Henrik Lundqvist.
Again, just not able to elevate that puck with Lundqvist down. That's really the only area of the ice that is open or on that net is when the goaltender moves right to left in that particular play. Great work by Lundqvist. Beautiful pass again by Patrick Elias.
Great action there.
Rolled around
yesterday, yeah. Too. Sorry, Doc.
Yeah, no, I'm sorry.
Yesterday for the Devils. He and Zajac and Clarkson had a great afternoon for the Devils in their 16 win yesterday.
Defense is so important. Eddie pointed out what the Devils normally can do when they excel, and that's play team defense. The Rangers are fifth best in the lead in goals against average. Zero up on the board attests to that. Chicago, Ottawa, and Boston are the three best when it comes to the Jennings Trophy, which will be handed out after Boston's last game on Saturday, or rather Sunday of next week, to someone. It's the fewest total goals. Chicago with 94, but Boston doing itself a big favor. Ottawa 96, Boston 97, and they played a game and did not give up any earlier this afternoon. Punched along by Stroman. And carried back up by Ryan McDonough. Sized up by Jedlicki. McDonough with a shot, and Brodeur is able to grab and then hang on. Taylor Pyatt has recorded the only goal of the second period to give his team a three-goal lead. Number 11 is retired here. Marc Messier wore that proudly. This is one of the bigger days in the rivalry between these two. He said, "We will win the game." That was Game 6, which forced Game 7, which went to multiple overtimes. There was an empty netter. And among those suited up for the game, that guy, number 12, Eddie Olczyk.
Long time ago. That was maybe one of the best games I've ever seen a goaltender play, and that being Mike Richter. He gave us an opportunity to be within one goal headed to the third period.
Callahan's shot was pat stopped by Brodeur, who was in for two of the three goals, of course, the empty net or not. Devils scored the first two in that Game 6. Tom Chorsky hit the post, or it might have been three. And Mike Richter made a ton of saves. Years later, Mike Keenan was asked by me, "What did you say during the timeout you called after it was looking bad for your team?" He said, "I stared at Marc Messier. He did all the talking."
Well, when you step up and step out like that, and step to the forefront like that, speaks to the success that Mark had as a player in Edmonton, and then obviously followed him here to New York and be the leader of the Rangers that year.
Well, Tinkoff dubbed his shot, followed up by Brassard. So we've shown you close up two of the winningest general managers in the sport, in Lou Lamoriello first and Glenn Sather, who was near Marc Messier second. Brodeur gets some sarcastic applause. They are the gurus. It all began over 30 years ago in Edmonton for Glenn Sather.
He never likes those, by the way. He's always got a fresh one, and it's always on that side of his mouth. And he's stoic, but that's what he does. He never lights them up.
Smoke-free building. Can't. Volchenkov lobbed it ahead. And this is not a place that looks the other way on that stuff. But he's not inclined to anything. Punched on now for this one to go back now for Volchenkov. How is that? Is that okay?
Very
round,
good.
Round behind here is Powell. Well, he's not lighting it up when we see it, see? And this one floated on out to center as it's nubbed on across for Girardi. 4 minutes to go, second period. Devils have to win. Rangers want to win. Their want is better than the Devils have to right now. But still, 23 minutes to go and change in the afternoon. Larson hands across. Green with a drive. Was trying for Henrique. Henrique reaching in, trying to poke it free. Does get it. And then it's nudged on back to Green again. Slung over with a Larson. Then back to Green. Fires a shot. Deflected off of Lundqvist. And wide. Centering pass. Flag down there. It is handed on across for the carry back up by Kreider.
A couple of good looks for the Devils on the back end. Defenseman shooting the puck. Andy Green a couple of times. Steve Bernier doing a really good job in front of the net, battling, looking for loose pucks and trying to create a screen.
Ryan Klo brings it ahead. Rifle it across, and Nash could not take that. Zubris wheels, trying to step free. D'Agostini gains the zone one side. It is fired around behind where Zubris is after it, but Stroman prevails, and then is shuttered off by Zubris, and it's laid on back to the point. Jedlicki there, over to Tolinder. Tolinder back to Jedlicki once more. Shoots one that is directed up high by Girardi and pops over near Nash. Bang,
and gone out to Broussard at center. Pass is cut, floated on back by Kalinda. Hand pass has stopped the clock. Time to remind you of this. Wednesday night is rivalry night on the NBC Sports Network. This week, playoff positioning is on the line when the Red Wings battle the defending champion Kings. Wednesday night rivalry presented by Coors Light begins 6:30 Eastern on the NBC Sports Network.
Well, a missed opportunity here for the New Jersey Devils. Look at one too many men on the ice for the Rangers. The officials didn't see it. The Devils should be on a power play.
Peter DeBoer was furious. Ryan McDonough was the player that was too many men on. And Steve Miller is trying to explain it to the Devils bench right now, the linesman, saying, I had to call the offside there. I couldn't count the players. I was calling the offside. Yeah. Talk to the other guy.
That's not my call.
Yeah, exactly.
When you're down and you're battling to stay a part of the playoff push, you're going to get very emotional. And when you're down 3-0, you're looking for something to grasp onto.
That man did an unbelievable job with the Devils last year, I thought, getting them to the Stanley Cup final. And obviously they lost in Game 6, but what a coaching job he did last year.
Hidlitsky run into there and responds with Taylor Pyatt. Meanwhile, you watch as the guys are playing the puck now, but it comes back here, Pyatt and Jedlicki again, so we'll just watch there. I don't know why this interests me, but it does. I forgot my role there for a second. Here's Talinder turning along. Talinder, managed by a couple of Rangers, pushed one ahead that's helped along by Jedlicki to center. And then it comes on back to Jedlicki again. Under 2 minutes to go here in the second period. Zajac saw that one flick across. Rescued and fed on back now for McDonough. Off of Zuccarello and back in. Talk about the guys that came from Columbus or San Jose, and the fact that Zuccarello came back has been huge for the Rangers. The smallest guy, but one of the more significant players, especially when it comes to things like shootouts.
It raises the skill level as well up front for John Tortorella and the Rangers.
Haglund pivoting. One at Callahan.
Get out! Get out! Get out! Let's go!
Dragged free by Zajac, then knocked free. Careened on to be taken by Eliash. Moving back up with David Clarkson. Played it off the boards. Clarkson has Eliash in front, tried to golf it there, but in the way with Dan Girardi. Delgado twisted it ahead, and Callahan shoveled it out to center. Rattled it back in again, and around its world near Callahan, and we get a stoppage of play on an icing. Sidney Crosby has missed 8 games and is still 3 points ahead in the lead for the Art Ross Trophy. 56 points to Steven Stamkos's 53. Tampa Bay will be playing at home tonight against Carolina.
Doc, I have a question for you. Clarkson and Eliash, can they both stay potentially unrestricted free agents for the Devils? Do they both stay next year?
Boy, that's a tough call because of the salary cap coming down. It's been a hard call for them, and both of these guys have had strong seasons, though both of them wound up in the same collective funk that the team did. Clarkson is the leader in goal scorers and on the team, and Patrick Eliash had the co-lead with him yesterday. So they're the two most productive guys offensively this year in their contract year being up. And it is the way of Lou Lamoriello to not discuss these things during the season. So here is Giambi. Fed on around now for Larson in the last 10. A long-winded, I don't know. Here's Carter bringing it on.
Go.
Bernier, and that's it. Shots to 17 through 2 New Jersey, but 3-0 in the important goals for the Rangers. Coming up on the Discover Card intermission report, Liam, Mike, and Keith on the Rangers in control, and the Red Wings push for the playoffs, currently a single point out of 8. In that period, there were gong shots, and there was a terrific shot by Taylor Pyatt that made this a 3-0 Rangers lead after 2. here at Madison Square Garden Saturday. Don't miss the NHL Game of the Week. Same two teams right back here at Madison Square Garden. The NHL Game of the Week Saturday, 3 Eastern, only on NBC. Pretty decisive, isn't it? 3 years since they lost the 60-minute game when leading after two. Henrik Lundqvist will try to shut the door on the New Jersey Devils season. Nothing to save it for the team in white and black. It is Andy Green who will start it ahead and fire it back in. And it caught somebody offside. Shots were 12-10 New Jersey in the second period. Callahan, Stepan with goals for the Rangers in the first period. Piatt in the second. And this one fed back to be taken on by Larson. Menaced there by Haglund. Rattled around behind and Lundqvist sets it up. It is Stepan playing on to center. Carried back ahead by McDonough. And he drops one well wide. Off the outside of the cage, it is jabbed free by Larson, held up by Haglund, fired on around and pinching back in his Strome. Can't come up with it though Callahan can.
Good play there by Callahan, realizing, as you mentioned, Doc, the play by Strome pinching in. He's only able to be aggressive on the boards. He has that support, that trust factor by Callahan, filling in his defensive position.
It was just a couple of years after this arena opened, in the late 1960s, that there was a final day of the season in which the New York Rangers had to wind up defeating the Detroit Red Wings, who had clinched a spot in the playoffs the day before. And Emil Francis, the coach of the team, said, all my defensemen are coming into the top of the circle and we're going to let them have it. 65 shots, they defeated Detroit. And later on that night, the onus was on Montreal in a weird situation at Old Chicago Stadium. Montreal had to win the game or lose, and still in losing score a certain number of goals. And so they had to pull Rogie Bachon midway through the game, and the Blackhawks just lovingly filled the net with empty netters, and Montreal was out. And the whole scenario for how you break a tie was changed that summer. Inside the glass, here's Pierre.
Well, one of the positive things for the New York Rangers in their push for a playoff position, Henrik Lundqvist, and you've seen it here this afternoon. He's been outstanding. He's faced 18 shots, some of them pretty difficult, like Zajac, like Clarkson's, sometimes even uses his head, that time against Gionta. He's been exceptional, again, for the New York Rangers.
21 wins in his prior years that were full seasons. His totals were 30, 37, 37, 38. 35, 36, 39.
Doc and Eddie, the first time I saw him play, he was playing in Gothenburg for a program called For London. Even then, you could see a larger guy in net with tremendous athletic ability. He went on the backstop Greece internationally many times, obviously in the Olympics, but his size factor and his athleticism is fantastic. It really is.
Rifled back into the Zamboni corner. Kalinder could not make a play because of the work of Callahan. Goes back after him again. Meanwhile, it's kicked away from Haglund and is started up by Patrick Elliott. Led back on now to Travis Zajac. Zajac filtered it back in off the board to Lundqvist. Sent it from whence it came. Back on it came for the control by Zielinski. Along now to David Clarkson. Clarkson angled it back. Tolinder took it there. Tolinder rifled it across, and it is Zielinski firing one that is knocked down in front. And then hoisted on out as far as center, where Tolinder will not come up with it just yet, and then tumbles down to the ice, drawing a penalty from Callahan. Delayed call is on. Tolinder will start this on ahead. And so it is Eliash on the delayed call, gaining the zone. Eliash dropped, Henrique shot, and it got the glass. Bounced along to Tolinder, dropped off for Henrique. All of this on the delayed call. Led on to Kovalchuk. Had trouble controlling and then brushed it along further. Andy Green plays it there. Sent it around behind. It is held. And Zajac flipped one that is knifed off of Henrique. Tucked on back to Tolinder. Tolinder shoveled it across to Kovalchuk. All on the delayed call that will be whistled down.
You know, the penalty is going to be on Ryan Callahan, who was in a foot race here with Tolinder. Boy, it just looked like the Devils defenseman just went down on his own. I know Callahan was reaching in there,
I think what ended up getting called was the two hands on the stick when he reached in until Linder went down.
And then the stick, Rooney's got a good look at it, the official that makes the call, there's one, and then the stick putting a little pressure on the foot. I know, that's a tough one.
In that situation, I think the two hands did him in, because once you get that stick in there and the player loses his footing.
Harold, a shot that is divingly played back after the initial kick in front by Nash, and so it is Brodeur sliding it along to Kovalchuk. Well, guys, would you say this is it? Right here, or is it too early to say?
I think it's still too early, but this is a momentum opportunity here for the Devils. Yes, the ultimate is to score a goal while you're on the power play, the man advantage, but they got to generate some momentum here.
Kovalchuk to the back, sorry. Harold on across to Elliott. Elliott pulls, drags a couple of Rangers to him, then along to Clarkson. Guided up the board, flip right to Nash, who can start it back out for the Rangers. Devils goalie Marty Brodeur stops that one, and it is Kovalchuk to take. Ahead now to Adam Henrique, caught it back in, but caught a man offside. What do we have?
Elias is in trouble. He just lipped off to Chris Rooney, and I think Elias is going to get tossed. Yeah, he lipped off big time. He's going to get it. I'm right down here, Doc, and he's usually a gentleman, and this time he wasn't such a gentleman.
Well, not a good penalty there at all by Patrick Elias. Down three on a power play, that can't happen. Whether you've been around the block a few hundred times like Patrick Elias or a young player, not at this time.
There's Chris Rooney.
It's a second unsportsmanlike conduct penalty given to the Devils.
If you think back to Game 6 last year, Chris Rooney was one of the officials working in the Stanley Cup Final in Game 6. And the Devils didn't like some of the calls that went against them in that Game 6, even though the Kings were phenomenal. And they have long memories in this league, as you know, Eddie.
A time and a place. Not right now. Not when you're battling to try to continue to give yourself a chance to make the playoffs.
Kovalchuk holds, dances through traffic, but is denied the pass. Tremendous play there as Girardi, through a lot of traffic, able to carry it on ahead and then slip it on across. I beg your pardon, I thought that was Girardi. That was 6, not 5. I learned that in grade 1 in Indiana, but it did not translate to that one. Right-handed defenseman, number looked the same. All of this is weak, isn't it? Really weak. Okay, McDonough connects back across. Early stages, third period. Handed ahead and it's Nash trying to flip it on through. Controlled shorthandedly and then turned toward the goal, but we have still 20 seconds to go on the 4-against-4. Dancing ahead now is Zajac, able to gain the zone and hold. Zajac fed it across to Linder, shoots one, and that one blocked down. Punched on around. And then back to Girardi, no kidding this time, along to Delzato. And Delzato is able to send it back with a carry-on now by Rick Nash. So now it's no longer 4-against-4. It is a drive-off result that is stopped by Brodeur with the Rangers on the power play.
Boy, a beautiful play by Rick Nash. He understood that his team was going to go on a power play, and he bought some time as he entered the zone. Here's the time he buys. He draws two Devil penalty killers to him, and then Derek Brassard really never picked up his head to see where Marty Brodeur was patient, positioned in the net. But Brodeur was able to absorb it. The key there for Brodeur, not a rebound given up.
Nash, the shot leader on this team, and in the early part of the season, when things were a little more up for grabs and uncertain, he was the guy they counted on. Richards, side of the net. Ryan Callahan has made this a 4-0 game.
Pretty good precision, Eddie, on this one.
Boy, a lot of moving parts to this play. Watch what ends up happening. The Devils over pursuit. They chase up so high that leaves Brad Richards wide open right here. So now he's got all kinds of time to make a play. And Ryan Callahan, as Marty Brodeur is going for the poke check, he gets a piece of it. But he alley-oops it into the wide open net and behind Brodeur.
And anytime you got teams going tape to tape to tape to the back of the net, It involved precision, coaching, and awareness, and the Rangers had that right now in the power play. And I think the big reason why the trade deadline, they added all these moving parts, as you like to say, and it's helped their confidence in time.
Yeah, Brad Richards did a really good job. I mean, he had lots of time. He walked into an area that maybe he was going to be able to shoot the puck. He decided to move it down to Ryan Callahan. And he gets a fortunate bounce. But the right idea of taking it to the net.
Brad Richards. And number four,
it is Henry bringing it on. And dropping it back in. So John Moore comes by, and it is Gerard Callahan, his second goal. Richards, his second assist. Delzato, the other assist, at 5:13. Ryan Callahan with his 13th and 14th goals of this shortened season. As we were saying earlier, the measure of a captain is how things are when it is at its worst, or when the game is larger. That has been the case with Callahan before, and now to Linder, hands off. It's given by Kovalchuk for a shot that is held by Lundqvist from Jedlicki. 13:34 to go. Third period of play. The captain of the Rangers has a pair.
Right before the goal by Ryan Callahan, Johnny Moore moves this puck to Michael Delzato. Watch this play right here by Brad Richards. Looks like he's going to shoot, right? Head up. Going to pound it to the net. He does not. He pushed his puck right to the side, freezes Anton Volchenkov, and Callahan is able to find the back of the net. So that slight hesitation by Brad Richards froze the defense for the Devils. But again, over pursuit up high allowed them to set that up.
There's an offensive swagger to this team right now that they didn't have before. And that's going to cause some problems for some teams later on if, in fact, they do make the playoffs. A broken piece of glass.
Well, they tend to that. We'll tend to this bit of business. It's just to thrill you with the games that are scheduled here. Blues and the Avalanche tonight, 7 o'clock on the NBC Sports Network.
And tomorrow night on the NBC Sports Network, the Coyotes head to Detroit to take on the Red Wings.
And Pierre will be sandwiched in between two very narrow panes of glass. Bruins and Flyers, NBC Sports Network, Tuesday at 6:30.
And we will be in Detroit to see the LA Kings take on the Red Wings. Wednesday night, rivalry night on the NBC Sports Network.
Columbus later on tonight is in San Jose. On the other side of Detroit, Dallas will be in Los Angeles. San Jose has won three straight. The Kings have won five in a row at home. But those are all just, well, that's just meringue before the game starts, and then we get to the end, right? Because if Columbus and Dallas both lose, then Detroit would have games in hand on both, including two on Columbus, and would only need to make up 1 point. We hope this doesn't confuse you further, but here it is. Detroit and Dallas actually play the final day of the season. Down in Dallas, that may mean something or it may mean nothing by then.
A little bit of separation in between 6 and 7. Haven't seen that in a while. St. Louis Blues playing extremely well the last 10 or 11 games. I think they're 9-2 in their last 11.
Eddie, we talked about the trade deadline with the Rangers. How about the trade deadline for St. Louis? Adding Jay Bouwmeester and obviously Jordan Leopold. They've stabilized their defense. They play so many one-goal games. That St. Louis defense is rock solid right now. Unbelievable.
Got a lot of depth.
Yeah.
Guys able to skate them out of trouble, so to speak. Buy some time for your forwards, and nothing better as a forward in the National Hockey League or at any level to be able to know that you're going to get the pass on your stick instead of your backside or chasing after it. And those two players in particular, Leopold and Bouwmeester, to go along with Shattenkirk and Petrangelo, Barrett Jackman, Roman Polak, can certainly make plays to give their forwards an opportunity.
Any word on TJ Oshie? I know the team's saying he's day-to-day. He had a little surgical procedure this past week, but if they ever get him back, that helps a lot offensively.
A huge part for their team.
He is on the IR, as 35 players are off the 30 teams here at the end of the season.
Well, the Rangers came out early in this game, 34 seconds into the game. Breakdown and coverage for the Devils. Ryan Callahan with his 13, 34 seconds in. And then Derek Stepan off the beautiful shot pass by Ryan McDonough. Stepan's 16th. And then Taylor Pyatt in the second period, his fifth. And here in the third period, Richards to Callahan, second of the game, 14th on the season. Power play goal, 4-0.
Callahan with two goals in this game. He has had two prior career hat tricks. Both of those, much to the delight of the Rangers fans, were against the Philadelphia Flyers.
Ryan Callahan played for the Guelph Storm in the Ontario Hockey League, and for 2 years his line mate was Matt D'Agostini. And Callahan and D'Agostini have been looking at each other during this timeout. D'Agostini's two in from where I am, and Callahan's right there, so they've been chatting with one another through the glass, not really talking, but making eye contact with them.
Watch live NBC National games on NHL Game Center. Call Star NHL to download NHL Game Center and get a free premium upgrade on all tablets and Verizon 4G LTE smartphones. Neil Diamond was live at Fenway Park yesterday. And the unofficial anthem of Red Sox fans and sports fans in Boston has now been adopted elsewhere for good reason. Made, the game will resume. We really appreciate those pictures. 13:34 to go in the third period. Rangers in the lead over the New Jersey Devils 4-0. There are other games for the Devils to play this year, but none of significance after today unless they get four at least and a fifth in overtime or credited for one in a shootout. That is the dire strait that faces them here on the fifth floor of a 10-story building called Madison Square Garden in New York. A false start. And then Strom. Brassard tucked it on out. Nash reached for it there. Taken back by Ponikarovsky and handed across to Larson. Then spun on to Green. 13:15 to go. And it is handled by Henrik Lundqvist, but it won't matter. It's called back out to center on an offside.
And if you're the Devils, you got to start taking some chances now. Defenseman jumping in, defenseman pinching in, defenseman trying to make a two-on-two or a three-on-three, a four-on-three to give yourself any opportunity. And the Rangers certainly know that. So they're going to make sure that any even man situation or odd man situation going towards Marty Brodeur in a double zone is that they're going to get pucks in and force the Devils to come 200 feet.
Elias around behind, canceled off the icing. No, I guess they ruled not. Mixed signals there, but that's nothing new for an afternoon when things happen very quickly.
Eddie, Mike Milbury was talking about it. It doesn't seem like the Devils really brought their A game here this afternoon. At some point, does a sense of inevitability for me to say kick in for the Devils, and they say, you know what, this is just too big a mountain for us to climb?
Well, I think if you can start off the game and get a little bit of momentum here, but I think the Rangers just took any opportunity away from them early in this game. I mean, they just dictated the pace and came out and... Look, the Devils had some chances, but Henrik Lundqvist was called to the task. You get a goal 34 seconds in. Certainly, it's just human nature that some doubt creeps in, knowing of what's at stake as far as your playoff ability.
Callahan trying to fight his way in. Meanwhile, that knocked on to Stepan. Set it up to Delzato, but that one is blocked down. Devils started out, and the pass comes over for Patrick Elias. Knocked off his stick. And on back to center, and the Rangers charge on. Delzato trying to fight his way by. A little help from Haglund, but now it is regathered by Dan Girardi. Small plays make a huge difference, just as Girardi did a moment ago. A 4-0 lead for his team.
Oh, great pickup, Doug. That's exactly what happened. It was a 3-on-2, and then just a quick stick of Dan Girardi. Taking away the opportunity from Patrick Elias.
Frustration all around, and Patrick Elias comes over not happy, and he did everything he could to shatter that inanimate object in his hands. Obviously frustrated, potentially at the end of the road with the New Jersey Devils, which decides to exercise unrestricted free agency.
A pad stop is made by Lundqvist. He has a lot of credentials right. And in a difficult year for his team, his point a game was about as good as anyone's. We entered today with only one player that had averaged a point a game this season. That was 40 in 40 games for Rick Nash of the Rangers. But both of these teams have had difficulty scoring at times, as Eddie pointed out at the top. The Rangers seem to have solved that problem the last couple of games, and they've gotten four here this afternoon.
Yeah, think about Elliott. I mean, he could easily have a couple of assists in this game with the opportunities he set up with David Clarkson back in the first period, and then the opportunity for Travis Zajac in the second period. But again, Devils on the power play. Eliash takes an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty, and then once it went from 4-on-4 to 5-on-4 for the Rangers, Callahan scores.
Doc, fair to say one of the best Devils of all time?
Oh yeah, I don't think you'd get much of an argument there. And you've got, you know, three numbers that are retired. In Scott Stevens, Ken Danico, and Scott Niedermeyer. They have not had any forwards numbers retired. Certainly John McClain was one of the all-time great scorers in the history of the team. And Patrick Elias basically took over a lot of his records just through his longevity and his skill. Here is Delzato. And then Green.
Good play defensively against Chris Kreider. Good active stick there. Took away a possible chance for the Devils.
It is Larson, Kreider number 20 in blue. Has had a checkered year and has spent a good deal of time with Connecticut. And they began the day, though not playing, still having a chance at the last playoff berth in the Eastern Conference of the American Hockey League. They have to sit at home and wait for the outcome of games to know whether they have another game to play. This is the final day of the season in the American Hockey League. Henrique gave it on a cross, and it's Larson there. Floated one into the catching glove of Lundqvist. And play stopped with 10:21 to go here in the third. And there is Scott Stevens. There are guys who will kid now that they're retired that they knew that their shift was over when they saw him come over the boards for the other team.
Played against a lot of guys. The toughest guy ever played against right there, Scott Stevens. In every aspect of the game.
Remember that devastating hit on Paul Kariya back in the 0-3 Stanley Cup Final, Anaheim versus New Jersey.
What made a lot of players happy in his era is that he played with much more control in his game later in his career than he did early in his career.
Well, I thought we were going to say made a lot of people happy when he retired.
Oh, no, absolutely. But he would certainly seek out and knew exactly what you were going to do before you did it. Didn't mind wishing you a happy birthday about 4 months early.
Brian Engblom, a member of our NBC NHL crew, was a defense partner of Scott's back in those raucous days in Washington. And he said the first time he saw Scott line up a guy and come across the ice, he said, I thought he was going to get me. But it was the guy right in front of me, and he did indeed get it. Meanwhile, this is spun back in by Ponikarov, being stopped by Lundqvist. Past the halfway point of the third period. Time certainly dwindling down for the Devils. Very obvious comment at this time. They must win this game today. They are down by four. And the parts of the game we have seen thus far in the first 50 and change do not show any great inclination to battle back for four. Not only because of the Rangers' defensive scheme, but also this fire seems to not be there right now. Zajac played it ahead. Girardi flipped it out. It is not that they are not trying, it's just that they are spinning. This one chopped along by Girardi. Peeled off by Hagelin. And when that happens, you get into uncharacteristic errors like an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty, too. That is probably the more devastating of the situations that they had that resulted in a power play goal. This one forced back in, and Brodeur will stop it there. The chant by the Ranger crowd is season's over. Carter trickled it on through. Battled for there by Gionta and helped along by Eminger. Green saw that one waffle-boarded away by Lundqvist. Lundqvist with one shutout this year, going after number two. His totals in prior years have been enormous. 45 in his career, but is only 8 years long. Callahan dropped that one on, and it is taken over. The giveaway by Carter, the bring back by Stepan. Stepan, a shot that is slid away off of Brodeur. And then forced off the glass by Green, played on by Pyatt, trying to escape. Zuccarello's pass was flagged and brought on out to center.
Stepan didn't have much left in the tank. That was at the end of a long shift. Good stop by Brodeur.
I met a fan from Norway in the first intermission named John Jensen. I talked to him about Zuccarello, and he said, I never got a chance to see him play over there, but I sure have here. Is he ever impressive? Coming up, we'll have our Own Your Space presented by Avis.
Looking at our defensive play, which we did last year, you know, keeping everything to the outside and, you know, making sure Hanky can see everything. Just a matter of, you know, executing and, you know, playing with some desperation, especially now, always being, you know, in the right spot. You know, there's no little play out there. We can't have any little mistakes that cause goals. It takes time and space away as best you can. Keep them in check, you know, we'll have a chance to win.
Well, talking about owning your space, Dan Girardi is averaging over 25 minutes of ice time each and every night for the New York Rangers. Does everything, and the strength, hit or be hit, taking away that time and space, keeping teams to the outside. The most dangerous area on the ice is the middle. And then that little sound bite just talking about protect the middle, keep the opponents to the outside.
And a free rental to that man.
Thousands in the playoffs, yeah.
I don't think he'll need one. Offensive zone faceoff for New Jersey. We were talking about real estate earlier, and we were looking at those replays with you, Eddie, and I noticed the fans right behind the glass there. In this arena, the stands do not come right up to the glass, but they got very innovative a couple of years ago and put high chairs there, so there's one row right along the glass. To Linder, a shot. And they are not free, by the way. Played back along now for the carry back up by the Rangers. They've got a 4-on-2 development, now a 3-on-2. Richards fed it across, and it's jabbed away.
Nice play there by Matt D'Agostini. You're right, Doug. It was going to be a 4-on-2, but D'Agostini, look, he was shot out of a cannon through the middle of the ice to make that good defensive play.
Jedlicki saw that one broken up by Pyatt. Fed along now for Richards, and a save made by Brodeur. Driving to the net was Zuccarello. And so the clock ticks down to the last 7 minutes of regulation time. The shot's 22-21, New Jersey. And so Brodeur just allows it to be played behind by Peter Harrell. Rangers' defensive average will go down further unless there is a Devils onslaught here today. Dipped on back now for Darryl Powell. Handed on to Strawman. And Strawman nudged it on. Kreider trying to work his way further. Back along, and they've got Loktyanov open for a shot. He scores! Loktyanov has broken the shutout bid of Lundqvist. So now it is 4-1.
Well, there was a delayed penalty coming up. I think it was that late hit there by Darryl Powell. But Ilya Kovalchuk to Loktyanov, and I think this goes under the glove of Henrik Lundqvist.
Anton Stralman trying to jump up into the rush, but there was a turnover. There's a hit from Darryl Powell. That was going to be interference. But Stralman tried to jump up into the rush. He was the right defenseman there. McDonough covered the entire ice surface. That leads to the wide open opportunity for Loktyanov.
At 13:30, eighth goal of the year for Loktyanov. On comes Zajac, drops to Clarkson, and his shot was blocked away. Clarkson saw that one knocked loose and carried on by Ryan Callahan. Callahan gaining the zone. They try to follow up and wiping out there, though driving to the net was Zuccarello. Meanwhile, it is flung for another try in front that does not work from Stepo.
How about that pass by Girardi early on? Pretty good vision by Danny Girardi there.
Nothing soft about that pass.
Since we no longer see wood sticks, it could have broken the stick. Angled on out to center where Claude tipped it back in. And Talinder going to get it there. We talked earlier about a game in Chicago where Montreal pulled their goaltender way early because they needed goals. 5:20 to go. We'll leave this question with you as we head to break. When? 4-1 Rangers. Marty Brodeur is at the bench having some words with Andy Green.
Must have heard you, Doc. You posed that question right before we went to TV timeout.
There isn't really much to save it for, is there? Well, Eliáš back to Kovalchuk. Eliáš feeds one along the boards. Careened off the back. Clarkson up with it there. Clarkson second effort. Got it to Eliáš. Then back to Kovalchuk. Back to Eliáš. Pretty well challenged that time. It's thrown in front. And a backhand attempt is snuffed out by the Rangers. Going for it. Haglund played around behind though. Centering pass. They whack at it. And it is loose in. And comes onto the back now for Kovalchuk. Laid to the outside. Patrick Eliáš shoots one. And that one turned aside. And then it is a net ahead. A hat-trick goal was potentially there. A pass ahead and a penalty coming up as Haglund was hooked. And we get the call. It'll be on Kovalchuk.
Kovalchuk, yes, Doc.
So Brodeur back into the cage.
Haglund skating through the neutral zone, and there's the stick right into the hands and the body of Haglund.
That was a beautiful play there by Ryan Callahan to get the puck to Haglund. Let's remember, the Devils started off this season 8-1-3 to start the season. And they're 440 away from not being in the playoffs.
That one deflected out of play.
And how do you think about losing Zach Parise to unrestricted free agency? You lose Ilya Kovalchuk for a good portion of the year because of a shoulder problem. You see him flexing his shoulder right there. And you don't have Marty Brodeur. You lose 68 goals from last year's roster plus Marty Brodeur for a good portion of the season. Not too many teams can overcome what the Devils have had to face this year.
We apologize to the management of the Russian national team who probably watched that and are a little worried should he become available at the end of this season for the World Championships that are being held in Sweden and Finland. Players whose teams don't make the playoffs wind up becoming big targets for phone calls as soon as the mathematics is determined. 4:05 left.
One of those players is going to play tonight. Steven Stamkos is on the record saying he would like to go represent Canada.
Back ahead now for Zuccarello, and a scorching shot that was wide. We began the day with 30 teams and 22 remaining in contention. It will be 21 at the end of the next 3:43. Handed on around now for A feed to the back that was kept alive. Richards rifled it in front. It went off Zuccarello. Played on by Carter. And Carter has Ponikarovsky at center. Wedged off by John Moore. Coming by is Carter. Carter with a short side shot. And then he collides with Lundqvist. And play continues. Wow. 38 to go. Played on out to center and can be carried ahead by Chapek by Broussard. Broussard had that one knocked down by Zajac. Zajac wants to step ahead with it. Got it across to Patrick Elias. 23 left on the Kovalchuk penalty. Green, toe drag, fed it on for Volchenko. And there are a lot of blue shirts headed that way. Nash, a shot that is robbed by Brodeur. 2:45 to go, 7 seconds left on the minor penalty to Kovalchuk. Ryan Klo able to take his own pass and consume more time. To the back it comes now. McDonough shot! And that one deflected wide by Volchenko. Played along by Green. Then Volchenko angled it off to Patrick Elliott. And it's all a matter of just containing the puck. 2:15 to go, and the Devils need three. Brodeur remains in the goal crease for now, and perhaps indefinitely to the end. Harold threw it ahead, directed on by Zubras, punched across off of Henrik. Trying to work his way further, and now Brodeur hustles to the bench, so the net is empty again. The Devils will try to pour them in. Across it comes to Hagelin, skipped it on out to center. Callahan is out for the Rangers. Owning two goals, he was sacrificial earlier in handing off when the net was empty.
The Rangers fans wanted Lundqvist to take a shot at the net there when he went up and played that puck.
He can handle it well enough, can't it here? It's dropped on now for Zydlitzky, fed on through, and after it is Kovalchuk knocked away from him. Harold will hustle back down as this one will go for an icing touchdown if he gets there. And the ruling is he did not. Callahan's hustle paid off. But now it's Henrik with a minute 15 to go. Ponikarovsky holds, delays, Elias moving on. Close in, it was off. Kovalchuk was right near there too, and it's played back along now for Elias once more. Once Henrik, but then McDonough. Reaching in, Elias. Trying to fend it off in the final minute. Elias with it again. Shoots one that is deflected up to the high glass.
With a good block shot there by Darrell Powell.
To center it comes, and Larson. Off of Elias and back. And up into the mesh as charging for it was Asham, the ex-Devil, Islander, Penguin, and Flyer.
Good stick there by Adam Larson to deny the empty net, but talked about that hustle by Ryan Callahan to negate the icing. Boy, another dangerous play going straight into those boards to negate the icing. We've talked a lot about the possibility of a hybrid icing ever coming to the National Hockey League, and that's in one of those situations there where a lot of the icings players are going straight in, a very dangerous play because of the let-up aspect of just trying to touch that puck to make it an icing call or to negate the icing call.
Dealt right back in again. Brodeur around behind to handle. A game that was huge for the New York Rangers. They struck very early, 34 seconds in on a goal from Callahan, and did not look back. 16.2 to go, and one last faceoff.
Now for Henrik Lundqvist and the New York Rangers, they're going to move on to South Florida. They're actually leaving tonight right after the game. They don't play till Tuesday, so a nice little reward. Their next game's in Carolina on the 25th, Thursday. So they've got some downtime and some rest and rehab, and obviously important games for them. But Eddie, as you know, and Doc, they're still in this huge thing called a playoff push.
One of the things they have been looking at is the Winnipeg Jets, but the Jets on their own could move up to third place. Asham is gone and gives away a stick. Nice gesture at the end of the day. It was a 10-minute misconduct on Asham. But the Jets could wind up
DeBoer just got kicked out of the game.
Okay, wow. So that's it for that.
It's again, this is something that's a carryover. And Chris Rooney, this comes from last year in the Stanley Cup final.
Look, you got 16 seconds left. You let the coach air it out. You already gave him a bench minor a little bit earlier. This is where I think you just let him air it out and finish the game. You don't even stand in front of the bench.
Off the tie-up, it is Jedlinski. And then it is rolled across for a play for Carter. Devils eliminated the Rangers in the conference final last year. And it is the Rangers who will prevent the Devils from even getting into the playoffs this year by a score of 4-1. Henrik Lundqvist faced 27 and got 26. Martin Brodeur 22 and got 18. Two more points for the Rangers. And so they look up even higher. Ilya Kovalchuk with the last word. And in the background, the old instrumental from 50 years ago, the Rangers victory song. This is a custom of the Rangers going back almost a decade, saluting the fans. A week from today, they draw the line under the number 8 spot in both the East and the Western Conference. There is no surety as to who will be in that spot to face the number 1s. The number 1s are sure. The Chicago Blackhawks in the West, the Pittsburgh Penguins in the East.
Well, lots of confidence for this team right here. The New York Rangers scoring goals. 18 goals the last three games for the New York Rangers.
Pittsburgh, Boston, Montreal, and Toronto have clinched. But even with 8 full days to go and still some games tonight, the others are uncertain. It is the nature of life in general. Washington and Winnipeg are the number 1 challenge that left to be solved, and that will be the Southeast Division as you see Derek Stepan salute the crowd. Was quite a day, 17,200. Some were wearing red with the horns and tail. They were disappointed. Those with the diagonal letters were not. The final at 4-1. Coming up next here on NBC, except on the West Coast, it's your local news. Then at 7, 6 Central, it's The Voice, followed by an all-new, all-star celebrity apprentice. Over on the NBC Sports Network tonight, the push for the playoff continues as the Blues try to get by the Avalanche, and the Detroit Red Wings will be desperate for a win when they battle the reigning Stanley Cup champion Kings on our Wednesday night rivalry, presented by Coors Light. For Mary O'Marois, Bob Hoffmeyer, Pierre McGuire, Eddie Olczyk, Doc Emrick saying so long from Manhattan.